Hello everyone, welcome to Medica Cardio Talks Series 11. I am Dr. Dilip Kumar and today I am joined by Dr. Arindam Pandey, he is Senior Interventional Cardiologist with us, and Mr. Arnab, he is in charge cath lab technician. So today's cardio talk is a little special because we are talking about ourselves, our safety, because we have got some disturbing news about one or two of our colleagues have got some malignancy because they are working in cath labs. So it's pertinent to know the radiation hazards. We can't thoroughly rule out radiation problems for us, but definitely we can avoid it to the minimum if we take precautions. So let me turn to Dr. Arindam first. Could you tell us in brief how exactly the adverse events happen and what are the adverse effect of radiation for healthcare workers?
Yeah, this is a very important question because the adverse effect of radiation can be of two types. First one, which is not related to the dose, that means stochastic. That means if you got exposed to some radiation, then after that radiation exposure, it is not mandatory how much radiation you got exposed, but there can be some mutation in your body and that can lead to some development of malignancy. And second one, second type of radiation hazard is actually dose dependent, which is known as deterministic. So here the amount of, you know, daily exposure can actually accumulate, and cumulative effect is important. Say for example, up to 0 to 2 gray there is no effect, no evident, you know, problem is seen. Now if gradually it goes up, say for example 2 to 5, then you will start developing erythema of your skin. And if it is very high, if it is going beyond 15 gray, then there are possibility that your skin can totally get atrophied. So there might be other important skin manifestation, and they are mostly dose related. So we must understand little exposure can cause you trouble. Again, gradual cumulative exposure can also lead to some other form of troubles.
Right. And so it's important to keep the radiation dose less than 2 gray, isn't it?
Yes.
And now may I turn to Arnab. So could tell us the ways by which we can avoid the unnecessary radiation in cath lab?
Right. Yeah, for reducing the dose, it is very important to know few factors, like a few of the things we should follow in the lab, how we can minimize the dose. See, like without radiation we can't work, we have to work with the radiation, but at the same time we should not forget that the dose need to be reduced. Like for simple things, like for a child case, when you are doing a pediatric patients, so there we have to think that as the child heart rate is more, so there we need to increase the
frame rate in the pediatric population.
Yeah.
Around 45-50?
Yeah, it's around 30 frame per second.
Yeah, and but in pacemakers, I suppose we can keep it less.
We can make it as less as possible, like 7.5 rates or 3.5 frame per second also we can.
Correct. So, and for coronaries, I think 15.
Yeah, for coronary, so, we can carry on with the 15 frame per second. But for other cases, there the radiation is less, we can reduce frame per second. You can make it 3.5 to 7.
Correct. So I think we have to, each case basis, we have to change the, you know, dosing pattern and the frame rates.
Absolutely.
If we are taking a kind of pacemaker, CRTs, ICDs or electrophysiology cases, it should be 7.5 to 10 frames.
Right.
And for coronary cases, okay. And we have to store fluoros, you know, fluorescence.
Yeah. This is another important thing, that like whenever we are doing a procedure, there we do in a two mode. One is the recording mode, one is the non-recording mode. So in that case, every time going in a recording mode, that is called cine mode, it increases the dose of, I mean the radiation dose, it increases. So there we have to do the fluoro save. So whatever we are doing fluoro, that if we save it, that can be stored in the, I mean in our data, and that can be resumed from for any future cases. So there fluoro save is a very important.
Right.
So another thing,
and
is that,
could you tell us something about the table distance from the tube and the detector, how does it matter?
See, basically there are three layers. One is the tube, the second one is the patient table or the patient, and the third one is the detector. So we always say that from tube to patient distance, it should be as maximum as possible, and from the table to detector, it is as low as possible. So there we can reduce the dose as much as possible.
Correct.
And the last one is the collimation. If we say one is the hard collimation, one is the soft collimation. See, for soft collimation, we can reduce the dose at the same time. Hard collimation is actually reduce the scattered radiation. The more and more you use a hard collimation, obviously our purpose should be fulfilled for what we are doing, the angiography or angioplasty. So if you are using as much as possible hard collimation, it will reduce the scattered radiation, which is very important.
And Arindam, we have seen some angiograms which was taken in a zoom mode, and sometimes we see in a lower magnification mode. So lower magnification mode is always giving us less radiation to the the operator and all the associate staffs. So what do you practice in your lab, in our lab? What practice is a magnification or a field of view should be larger or smaller?
So let me start answering this question with my experience. So I had some observership in US in a hospital, Cedars Sinai Hospital. So in that hospital, what was a striking thing which came to my notice is they were actually never allowing any MAC images. They were working always in DMAC, and there mostly the catheter engagement and most of the other things in AP. So they were not tilting the tube. So both these things are actually to reduce the radiation. After retarding, I also tried to practice that, but many a time it may not be possible to work only in DMAC mode. In some of the situation, you might need to MAC it.
So correct.
More you MAC, more is the chance of radiation.
Yes, so.
But you must clearly understand, increasing the image size actually also increases the radiation. So do not do it without a proper solid resin.
Right. So the angiograms can be recorded in the low magnification, and that is what we want to give a clear message to everyone. And by the way, what is the maximum permissible radiation dose for a healthcare worker?
Yearly. So, yeah, it is said that over a period of 5 years, maximum 50 millisievert is actually allowed. And how do we monitor? We do have this TLD badge. So this badge you should wear every time whenever you are entering the lab. And what it does, it actually detects the cumulative radiation exposure, and it should be periodically monitored how much radiation you are already exposed, and we should keep a log out of that. And if it is going beyond the permissible limit, the operator or the healthcare worker should be barred from entering the cath lab.
Right.
That is how ideally it should be.
Yeah, I think it's time to high time to realize that some very stringent and strict action have to be taken by the health department and the in charge of the cath lab. No one should be allowed, and strict protocols should be followed, because it is for all of us, the safety protocols. So I will turn to Arnav again about something, glass seals which are there in cath lab, the above the table and below the table. So is this being used properly in our cath lab?
Yeah, this is very important things. Like for every procedure, we are supposed to use the glass, what is called the lead glass. One will be in the below, so that it's basically prevents the scattered radiation from the tube, and at the same time the top one, the top lead glass, which will prevent scattered radiation after emitting the radiation from the patient body. So that too is very important, and in our lab it is a regular practice. We do use the glasses from the up on also, from the lower also.
Sure. So I have gone and worked in different cath labs outside, and I have seen there is no way mentioned and presence of these glass protectors. So this is a wrong kind of practice which is happening. We have to take care of ourselves. And these glass seals are very, very important.
Yeah, very important. I'll share my experience. When I used to be a DM student 8-9 years back, in my hospital, my college, it was not at all a practice to use those glass.
Yeah.
Later on, I understood the importance of those glasses.
Yes.
So they are very
important. And then the working capacity, you can get more fatigue, and even if you are thankfully, if you are not having any stochastic effect, but definitely will have deterministic effect on your body. So finally, I will ask Arindam again about, are you happy with the present lead appliance which we use, or is there any new development about the newer antimony based mask? So what is your idea?
I'm not at all happy with the current lead appliance which we are wearing, because if I do too many cases in a single particular day, I get low back pain. That is the common thing, because they are very heavy. And not only that, they are not as good as we think about them. You know, lead being very, very inert, they prevent the radiation. Nowadays, there has been development of antimony bismuth lead apron, which are not only very, very light, they also are actually better in terms of radiation protection.
Right.
And there are actually, we'll go, you know, if we go further detail, there are two types of this antimony, you know, bismuth lead aprons. One is actually, the better one is there are two layers, two different layers. And the other one, they mix it up. So in research, it was found that the two layered antimony bismuth lead apron are far, far superior, because they do have some important advantage. You know, you can also tell.
Yeah, I think, there are less chances of K effect and what we call it fluorescence, and
yes,
scattering is less.
Yes.
So, and this is lighter as well. So it also reduces the orthopedic problems for all of us who are working, you know, in radiation zone. So, dear friends, today's Medica Cardio Talks was for all of us. We have to protect ourselves, and it should not be something like we have, wore jacket and our job is done. We have to take care of our, you know, eyes. We have to take care of we have to wear the glasses, the neck collars, the kind of complete jacket. And we have discussed about all the ways and means by which we can reduce the radiation. I hope the practice will change for the better, and we all healthcare workers will be able to do and deliver in a better manner to all the patients who are coming to us. Thank you so much for your time.